All right, guys, so this was something you guys worked on Friday, and this is going to be combining a bunch of different things on these couple sheets. I'm just going to review it. What was the rule that we have about big to small and small to big? Okay, so if we go from small unit of measurement, like inches, to a bigger unit of measurement, like feet, we're going to divide. And if we go from a bigger unit of measurement, like miles, to a smaller unit of measurement, like feet, then we multiply. Okay? And if you need your conversion chart out for this, please use it. If you don't know where it is, remember, it's right here on 16-1. You have those numbers there. And I also will be giving you another conversion chart today in class. All right. So for the first one, we're going from pounds to ounces. All right. Now, we know that there are 16 ounces in 1 pound, correct? So what do we do here? How do we get this answer right here? What do? We multiply it by what? 16. So 2 times 16 is what?
32.
And I just kind of just go down the line for each one, right? All these, we're going to multiply it by 16. All right. So 3 pounds is how many ounces? 48. 4 pounds is how many ounces? 5 pounds is how many ounces? 80. Okay, it's the first one, baby. It says right here 4. I think they're all labeled like, yeah. Yeah. So this is page 4 right here. See that? Okay. Same thing here. If we know that 1 ton is 2,000 pounds, right? So we got to multiply. So 2 tons is how many pounds? 4,000. And 3 tons is how many? 6,000. And 4 tons is how many?
8,000.
So all you're doing is converting, right? All you're doing is either multiplying or dividing. And 5 tons is 10,000. Now for the next part here, it says fill in the blanks. This one we're going to have to multiply or divide. Divide. Why are we dividing? A small ounces is like I told you, you know, it's light. It's a small thing. And then to pounds is bigger. So we're going to divide. What are we dividing?
96 divided by
16. Why
16? Because that's how many ounces
are in a pound. Okay, we know that. And if you don't remember that, remember, use your cheat sheet. There's 16 ounces and 1 pound. All right. 96 divided by 16. Did y'all figure that out? 6. So 6 times 16 is 96. Okay. All right. What about this one? 12,000 pounds is equal to how many tons? What are we doing? Dividing or multiplying? Dividing. What are we dividing? 2,000, because we know that there are 2,000 pounds in 1 ton. And this is something you can do with mouth to mouth. You can cross out that zero and cross out that one. Cross out that zero and cross out that one. Cross out that zero and cross out that one. 2 can go into 12 how many times?
6.
So 12,000 pounds is 6 tons. All right, next one. 9 pounds is equal to how many ounces? How do I get that? Why are you multiplying?
Because it's a big to small.
Yeah, this pounds is heavier, right? Pounds is bigger than ounces. So we're multiplying. What are we multiplying?
9 and 16.
Why are we doing 16?
Because that's how many ounces are in a pound.
There's 16 ounces and 1 pound. 9 times 16 is what? 144. If you need to come sit down here, you can, bud. All right, now this one's a little bit different. We're going to convert, and then we're going to add, okay? And this is where we're going to elevate it a little bit. So let's read it. A newborn baby weighs how much? 6 pounds and 11 ounces. So we've got the weight. We know for sure right now, this baby weighs 6 pounds, 11 ounces. Okay. It says how many total ounces does the baby weigh? So we've got to convert all of this to ounces. All right. So we know we're going to do 6. Are we going to multiply or divide? Multiply. What are we multiplying? 16. So, because that's how many ounces are in pounds. So 6 times 16 is what? 96. But then here's the deal. Don't we have some ounces left over that we need to add? Plus 11. So 96 ounces plus 11 ounces is what? 107? So that baby weighs 107 ounces. Next question. A truck weighs 3 tons. So 3, remember capital T. How many pounds does a truck weigh? Why 6,000? We're going to multiply by 2,000. And that's going to equal 6,000 pounds. With a what?
At the top, you can see
it. Okay. Awesome. All right. So, in a moment, we're going to go over this one here, 5. And this has the fluid ounces, the cups, the pints, quarts, gallons, all that. Okay. Let's continue. All right, let's continue. All right, so for this one's different. This is going to be the that big G. So if you want to, you can draw your big G. I will be giving you guys a sheet. And then we also have it still on the board. Remember, there are 8 fluid ounces in a cup. So this is different than the ounces, which are 16 ounces in a pound. All right. What's that? Yeah. You remembered it. All right, let's go ahead and start. So we know that there are 8 fluid ounces in a cup. So 1 times 8 is 8. Okay, so what do we do here? Multiply it. 2 times 8 is 16. 3 times 8 is... And 4 times 8 is... You guys are on a roll. Who? Yeah. I'm recording it. I'm recording for the kiddos at home. Hi, people who are sick. All right, so we know that there's 2 cups and 1 pint, right? So there's 2 cups and 1 pint. Same thing. So there are 4 cups and 2 pints, and there are 6 cups and 3 pints, and there are 8 cups and 4 pints. All right, same thing here. There are 2 pints in 1 quart. So 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8. Good. All right, we got the big gallon. We have the big gallon. There are 4 quarts in 1 gallon. Questions on that? All right. Now, for this one, we're going from a smaller unit of measurement, a cup, to a pint. Cup is smaller than a pint. Because it's smaller, we're going to do what?
Divide.
And what are we divided? How many cups are there in a pint?
2
cups are in 1 pint. So 12 divided by 2 is 6. So 12 cups and 6 pints are the same. All right. Next, we have quarts to gallons. All right, how many quarts are in 1 gallon? How many quarts? 4. So are we multiplying or dividing? Why are we dividing? Quarts are smaller than gallons. So 16 divided by 4 is 4. Good. All right, how many fluid ounces are in 1 cup?
8.
And because we're going from a bigger unit of measurement to a smaller unit, a fluid ounce is going to be like like when you have like a teaspoon, right? The amount of water. So just think about that. So we multiply or dividing. Multiplying from cups to fluid ounces, right? From a bigger unit to a smaller unit. What's 7 times 8? 56. All right. Answer each measurement word problem. A restaurant makes 3 gallons of tea. So 3 gallons of tea. How many pints of tea is this? Now, here's the deal. It didn't do what? It doesn't. But here's the deal. We know with 3 gallons, right? We know that how many pints are in 1 gallon. So there are in 1 gallon, 2, 4, 6, 8 pints in 1 gallon. All right? So what do we do here? That makes us how much? 24 pints. A recipe calls for 5 cups of milk. How many fluid ounces are equivalent to 5 cups? So how many ounces are in 1 cup? 8. Are we multiplying or are we dividing? Multiplying, because a cup is bigger than a fluid ounce. So 5 times 8 is what? 40 fluid ounces. Okay. Guys, remember, if you're getting these wrong, if you're not understanding something, you need to say something to me, send me an email, whatever it may be that helps you so I can know what I can do to assist you. Okay. All right. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to move on to this page. And this page has the number 1 up here at top. All right, let's finish going over this. All right, this one's going to be the length. So we know that there are 12 inches in a foot. 1 times 12 is 12. All right, let's keep going. So 2 times 12 is? And 3 times 12? 4 times 12? 5 times 12? Awesome. All right, now how many feet are in a yard? 3. Same thing, just going down the row. Awesome. All right, now let's fill in the blanks for this one. 24 feet is equivalent to how many yards? Are we multiplying or dividing here? Dividing, what are we dividing? 3, why 3? 3 feet. Yep, there are 3 feet in a yard, so that's going to be 8. All right, 9 feet to inches. Are we multiplying or dividing? Multiplying, because we're going from big to small. And how many inches are in a foot? 12. So 9 times 12. All right. And then 60 inches to feet. Are we multiplying or dividing? Why are we dividing? Smaller unit of measurement to a bigger unit. And what are we dividing? 12. Why 12?
Because
there's 12 inches in a foot. So 60 divided by 12 is what?
5.
All right. Jessica has 6 feet of string. How many inches of string does she have? So 6 feet. How many inches does she have? What are we doing here? Multiplying or dividing? Why are we multiplying? Bigger to small. What are we multiplying? Why 12? There are 12 inches in a foot. And 6 times 12 is what? Awesome. Miguel needs to walk 9 yards after school. How many feet are equivalent to yards? You can't see? Oh, my camera. Hold on. Sorry about that. All right. So are we multiplying or dividing here? Why are we multiplying? Big to small, and how many feet are in a yard? 3. So what's 9 times 3? 27 feet. Questions on this? All right, so make sure those are complete and put this away. We will have another set like this, but it'll be with a metric system.